Welcome back to another Faith Food video clip via PastorJerome.com. My topic for this week is, what is true love? What exactly is true love? Most people think true love is when you see people walking in the park. In Colombo, Sri Lanka, people think they are people on Goldface Green with umbrellas overhead. I don't think that is true love. True love is divine true love in Jesus Christ. Those who know Jesus Christ, have experienced Him, they are the ones that really know what true love is. To begin with, I would like to remind you that in 1 John 2 and verse 6 it says, if you know Christ, if you claim to know Him, you should walk as He walked. Then how did Christ walk? What kind of a walk did Christ walk on earth? He is a living God. He is a living God. In Ephesians 5 and verse 2, it says that Christ walked in love. He walked in love. He walked in love so much so that He gave Himself up as a fragrant offering. So if you and I, if we want to walk as Christ walked, if you and I want to walk as Jesus walked, you and I have to walk in love. So what is this walk of love? Or how do we walk in love? We know that the Bible calls us in 2 Corinthians 5:7 to walk in faith. As it says in 2 Corinthians 5:7, our walk is not by what we see, but by faith in Jesus Christ. But do you know that in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, there is something greater than even faith. There is something greater than even miracles. There is something greater than all of this. That is walking in love. Because in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, it says, even if we give our bodies to be burnt, and even if we give all the food that we have, all the money and the wealth that we have, and still we don't have this thing called divine love, it is useless. It is useless. What real love for God would be when we say, yes, Lord. When we say, yes, Lord, anything you ask, anything you say, I am ready. I am willing, Lord. I am willing. Actually, Romans 12:1 says, when we offer ourselves up as a living sacrifice, that is love. That is love. That is a lifestyle of worship and love for God. It is actually a lifestyle of sacrifice. It's a sacrificial lifestyle. So, what is this sacrificial lifestyle all about? It's so easy to love those who love you. That's what Jesus said. It's so easy to love those who are your family members, those who have done good to you, so you do good to them. That we think that is love. But there is something higher than that. That is something higher than that, that only Christ and Christ alone can show us. Only Jesus and Jesus alone can reveal to us. And only the scripture can really teach us what is this real walk of love. We've got to remember Christ all the time, 24/7. We've got to all the time keep remembering our Lord and our Savior, Christ Jesus. Romans 5:8 says that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. So if we have this divine love, we will be able to love anyone, any sinner, we will be able to love. You know that while I'm talking to you, it talks to me as well. I keep talking to myself as well. You can be many, many years in the Lord, darling. My precious child of God, my precious servant of God, my precious brother, my precious sister. You can be many, many years in the Lord. You can be knowing the scriptures from Genesis to Revelation. But still, if you don't have divine love, love that flows from heaven and heaven alone, love that flows from knowing Christ alone, then we are useless. We are nothing, including myself, the one who is speaking to you and the ones who are watching. So actually in John 8:12, Jesus said, I am the light of the world. If you follow me and if you walk with me, you will never walk in darkness. So in 1 John 2:9, it says, we who claim to know Him, we know in 1 John 2:6, we claim to know Him and then we must walk in Him. If we claim to know Him and we claim to be are walking in light, if we say we are walking in the light and yet we hate somebody, we hate our brother, we hate our sister, we are having bitterness in our heart, then we are liars. We are liars. It says we are walking in darkness. We are not walking in the light. We are not walking in the light. I pray that this is not bringing condemnation, because Romans 8 and verse 1 says there is no condemnation to you and I who are walking in Jesus, walking in Christ. We are living in Christ, who claim to be in Christ. There is no condemnation. The word of God will never bring to us condemnation, but it will bring conviction. So it brings conviction. You know that in the Old Testament, we know that God called Moses to build the tabernacle, and we know how God called Solomon to build the temple. And God gave specific patterns. I want this and this and this. And you know, in the New Testament, as in the book of Corinthians, you and I are called to be the living temples. You and I are living temples, because the Holy Spirit now doesn't dwell in a man-made temple, not in a man-made temple, but we are the walking temples of Jesus Christ. 2 Corinthians 3:3 says you and I are living epistles, walking epistles of this Christian walk, of this Christ-like walk, of this walk of love. When you and I are met by people should be able to read about Jesus in and through our lives. So, as I said, the greatest of all this is love. In Matthew 5 verses 43 to 48, Jesus beautifully explains what is true love. True love is when you can really love those who have hurt you. True love is when you can really love and embrace those who have harmed you, those who have spoken ill about you. If you can really show love to them, you have divine love. You have the love of Christ in you, my precious brother, my precious sister. In verse 45 to 48, ending at 48, he says, be ye perfect as my Father in heaven is perfect. So if you want to be perfect in Christ, this is the only way when you can love. Think of Jesus. He was slapped, he was spat upon, his body was bruised. You know, in Matthew it says that he took a pole and they hit upon his head over and over and over again. Are people beating you up? Are people ridiculing you? Learn to love them, learn to forgive them, learn to be like Jesus. That is true love. You know, in Romans 13 verse 8, it says it is a debt that we owe. It is a debt. You are in debt, darling. You are in debt, not financial debts. You and I are not called to be in debt to people where finances are concerned, or goods or whatever, or worldly things. But you and I have a debt that we owe to God and to others, and that is to love others. To love others. In 1 John 4:19 to verse 21, it talks about what real love is. A real love is when we can love those who don't love us. That is real love. In verse 19, it says, we are not the ones who loved God first. He loved us. He loved us when we were sinners, when we were so evil, when we were so messed up. He still loved us. So why can't we love those who don't love us? We didn't love God those days. Only now we know what real love is, because we know the real love of God. It says, up to verse 21, it says, if you can love those who don't love you, that is true love. That is true love. And you are truly a child of the living God. You are truly a child of the Most High God. Before I conclude, I just want to share with you the benefits of this true love. If there are prayer requests that you have been praying to God constantly, day in, day out, and over the past many years, maybe months, maybe weeks, maybe days, and your prayers are not being answered, and you're saying, Lord, you spoke to Pastor Jerome, you said this is the year of the open door, and still these doors are being closed to me. Well, my brother, my sister, my precious servant of the Most High God, can it be unforgiveness? Can it be a bitter root of evil? Can it be? In Mark 11 verses 24, actually from verses 22 down up to about 25-26, Jesus says, yes, if you speak to this mountain, in verse 22 it says, have faith in God, and 23 down it says, if you have faith as a mustard seed and you speak to this great mountain, maybe your problem is like a mountain today, and if you can speak to this mountain and believe that it goes into the sea, and you believe that it's going to be answered, you are going to have it. But what does 24-25-26 say? What does it say? It says, when you are praying, even as you believe that your prayer is answered, it's going to be answered, yes. But it also says, if you have remembered something that you have against somebody else, go and be reconciled, forgive, and see whether your prayer won't be answered. So my precious brother, my precious sister, if there is a prayer request that you have today, this day, whatever time you may be watching this telecast, this faithful telecast, I would advise you, I would plead with you in Jesus Christ, forgive those who have wronged you and do good to yourself. Have your prayers answered, and you will be able to email Pastor Jerome and say, I am Jerome's mother. Actually, my name is Wendy, and I am Pastor Jerome's mother. And I would like to advise you. I would like to encourage you this day to forgive, because I am learning over the past so many years. I'm still learning this, and I'm reaping the benefits. Day in, day out, I can see God working miracles, not only through me, through my children as well. You and your whole family, your generations are going to be blessed by you just forgiving and telling the Lord, fill me with your love, fill me with that true love, Lord. Only today I know what true love is, what real love is. Real love is when we can love those who don't love us. So my precious brother, my precious sister, my precious servant of the Almighty God, I like to pray with you this day that God will help you this day to forgive those who have wronged you, so that all your prayer requests, all these needs that have not been met so far, will be answered in Jesus' name. So let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I pray for my precious brother, my precious sister, who is watching me over this telecast. Lord, I praise and I thank you, Lord, you who taught me and who you are still teaching me what is true divine love, what is true perfect love, Lord, when we can love those who are unlovable, when we can love the sinner, when we can love those who have sinned against us, when we can truly love those who have done wrong to us, those who have spoken against us, Lord, we forgive them. Lord, we forgive them, Lord, not only with our mouth, but from our heart, as in Matthew 18, verse 35 says, Lord, forgive from the heart. Today, this day, we choose to forgive them. We choose, Lord, to forgive them and to forget it. We are just going to put it behind us. I'm going to walk with you, Lord. I'm going to walk with you in love, Lord. I'm going to walk with you this sacrificial walk of life and of love. Truly, life will come when you walk in love, my precious brother, my sister. If you want to experience this real life of walking with Jesus, to experience this real life, then walk in love, walk in divine love, and experience this life that Christ alone died while we were yet sinners to give you and I this life, this abundant life. I praise and I thank my God, for He is a prayer answering God. He is a prayer hearing and a prayer answering God. Every need of yours today is going to be met, all because you have chosen to forgive those who have wronged you. I thank you and I praise you in Jesus' precious name. In Jesus' precious name. Amen.